Hey, welcome everybody. This is Ukulele Ves with my good friend, big European Tongue of Our Lord supporter. And we're here to do our...
Thank you.
You know, our prediction. Actually, it will be me predicting.
Because
we want to see if you make it the game.
He'll be watching, you know. He'll be watching to see what I say.
Absolutely. Okay, so I'm taking
it's
notes.
It's easier to tell which the score is because we called in correctly on the 42-21.
You know, with the Carolina Panthers game, and we want to make sure that we call it right again, because the last one we called was, we called it half right. We called, we predicted that the Philadelphia Eagles will score 31 points, and they actually did, and they won the game, but I lost, because I say 42.
For Miami Dolphins.
But we got 17, so at least there is
a half right, half
correct
wrong.
Answer there.
Yeah.
And so this is actually the third time we've actually guessed the correct
somebody
score.
Somebody got the right score. Yeah.
So we're going to try it again before I let everybody know what I'm doing. So, and then we'll put up the new videotape. We'll talk about breakdown what Mike McDaniel.
Oh, yeah, it was nice. Very nice video.
Talked about his who's possibly playing. Also an update on who's going to be playing. So make sure you listen in, because our new intro here that's coming up soon has it has a lot of different things in there. It has a couple of new sound bites and new graphics. So hang out. But make sure at the end you will see our prediction. So it'll be interesting if we hit one of them again or hit both of them, like in the Carolina game.
Very
all right, everybody, check us out soon. Here we go. Here's our intro.
We love it, we love it.
Take it easy.
Oh yeah, oh yeah, oh yeah, oh yeah. Oh yeah, oh yeah.
My body's pulling the same body to my door. And that last drive was a perfect example.
466 through the air for you today. Three touchdowns, Tyreek Hill. 466 yards for you today. Unbelievable day. Yeah, and Tyreek Hill with two touchdowns. What was working so well through the air for you guys today?
Well, we just stuck to our game plan. You know, for me, it was just going through my progression, working through my progression, not trying to make things up out there. And we stuck to that, so it was working for us.
So you see what Tua and Tyreek were able to do. On that last play, you know, that's something that we've been working on this offseason and even into training camp and all that stuff. So.
You had mentioned about Tua. I'm just curious, today he was named the AFC Offensive Player of the Week.
Which I don't find offensive. Seeing if you guys are awake.
And Tua, how good is this guy? He is really good, and he has stepped up in a way that I don't think a lot of people saw coming.
King of the Hill. Quarterbacks who can hold their own in the choreographed touchdown celebrations that you do, but like you look right at home in the end zone dancing with them. I know you got handshakes with all the receivers.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah. Well, a lot of it we do on Friday, so we.
And you gonna try to tell me a dude that you've never even played a preseason game with is more accurate than Patrick Mahomes, Tyreek Hill? Stay off the weed.
We love our talking heads on weed. I mean, we've got the hottest show on grass, but we meant it for the field, you know? Okay, so here is what's cool. We all want to find out who's playing, who's actually injured and who will be playing, because we have the list here. But let's hear what the first question was about some of the defensive people that we are really going to need tonight. Okay, here is the question.
Is Javon out of protocol? And then with...
No, he's not.
Thank you. That's good. And then,
but still working through it.
It's good information. Thank you.
Still working through it.
Your starting corners with Xavier and
don't know who they are.
I was going to ask you, if they go through practice today, well, there are no health issues, things go well, they look good to you, would you expect both of them to play something?
So everything's case by case with those two individuals.
I have a very good working relationship with them, and we communicate very well. So they both know what they mean to the team and what their, like, their desire to play, if they put themselves in harm's way, what it can do, you know, to the team. Much like Teron Armstead, where it's like a, and that's an earned right, because they're not just telling me, they've shown me they know how to prepare. So, you know, I think, like, literally nothing to do with any competitive advantages or any like, I really have to go through practice and listen to them. I'm already going to know I'm going to like the way they look, those two in particular, but it's about them understanding, which we've worked to this point to be in a working relationship like this, where they know the implications, they know what it's like to feel right, and they know that we have guys that we've really depended on all year, fortunately, that are able to make plays and orchestrate the defense if they're unable to. Obviously, we'd love to have them both. I wouldn't say that I'm prepared for either scenario for both players. And I really don't have a clue if they're going to play or not, which is fun, right?
It is a lot of fun. So let's just read out some of the names that was for week 8. River Craycraft is questionable. Javon Holland is questionable. Xavier Howard, questionable. Alec Ingold, questionable. Raheem Mostert, questionable. Nick Needham, questionable. Ramsey, Jalen Ramsey, questionable. Cam Smith, questionable. Connor Williams, questionable. Okay, and then we move down to keep moving down. Connor Williams, questionable. Braxton Berrios is not listed. Tyreek Hill's not listed. Kader Coho is not listed. Jalen Waddle's not listed. David Long is not listed. So those are the update information.
Or the very good
for today's game. Yeah. So does that mean that you can make prediction now?
Yeah.
It means I can actually make the prediction. So for me, what's really important was to see who was going to play, questionable and not listed. So one thing I know for sure is that I'll give you the answer now.
That is right.
But we had even more. In fact, we won't be able to go over the play that we thought we would go over with Mike McDaniel's Mike McDaniel's breakdown of Kader Coho. But we wanted to talk about that, but that's going to take too long. It's going to take more than 10 minutes. So we're just going to end it. But the prediction is, of course, we're calling it that.
Please, show us.
So how many points are we supposed to win by?
Well, I think I heard that maybe we should win by 9 points or something like that. I mean, you know, New England is underdog, playing a home game there for Miami Dolphins.
Okay. So, for me, what
I'm
see is that there's a lot of good things.
Yeah.
You know? Like what, like, come on, you must tell us the score, and then we can explain later. Okay, so, hey, but before I do that, here's the other things. One of the reasons why I made the suggestion, the score that I'm going to make is because when I look over here, look at the score here, look at the how many Alabama players are out
that
there
is right.
on the defense.
Yeah.
You know, Anthony Jennings, former Alabama teammate, Christian Barmore from Alabama, and also Mac Wilson Sr. Also, I think there are more, but for now, that's on the defense. These are the guys. And the one guy I also added in there was Jalani Tabai. He's from the islands.
Some
more in Hawaii, but I think he is from California. So it'll be interesting game.
You know,
they are
very good player.
They had one sack, 6 quarterback hits playing against against the Buffalo Bills. So this was the stats from that. So Buffalo ran 265 yards.
Yeah.
And
I mean, of receiving, and then they also were able to rush for 81 yards. And I think we can do that, so we can match those scores, you know. And then we'll see what happens. You know, of course, they won that game 29-25.
Okay.
So what do I guess the game for ours?
Yeah.
Now, I'm looking there, and they only had one sack.
Yeah.
You think they'll sack two of this one? Man, maybe they'll have one, but most likely not. It would be nice not to have a zero because they did it already. But it depends. It's difficult because of all the people hurt, so it'll be hard to keep the... keep Tua under zero or sack. So there will be one or two in there.
Okay.
Could be.
Yeah. Okay.
Okay. So then, okay, we are ready. Drum roll.
What is your prediction?
Yeah. Okay. So my prediction was that
Miami
would be, New England will score 24 points.
Okay.
So and then Miami will win about
35-24. Oh, man. I'm sure Tua will be happy in the Dolphin fans. Let's go.